able to welcome back to my channel. Happy New Year, happy 2019. I know the beginning of the new year is supposed to be about looking forward and making plans for the year ahead. However, I'm going to be starting my new year by looking back. As you probably know, if you've been watching my videos, my sporadic videos, then you'll know that the last few months have involved a lot of life changes for me. And so I haven't been making and posting videos as I usually do. In fact, I didn't post haul videos and recap videos for November or December yet, which means that I still have some videos that I want to make that look back, and I'm going to be making those starting now. First of these videos is today. I'm going to be sharing the books that I acquired in November. I know I could just lump them together and make my November haul and my December haul together. However, in 2019, I'm going to be starting a video series where I'll need to have a little bit more accurate recording of what I did each month in the previous years. So I'm going to be making those videos and posting them. So stay tuned for the first of those videos, which is today's video, my November 2018 book haul. The three books that I got in November are, first is Washington Black by Ezio Duggan, and I got this copy. I previously had the English copy, which has the picture of the cloud cutter and an image of what we expect Washington Black might have looked like. This one is more the wanted poster, because Washington Black was a wanted man at some point in his life. If you're not familiar with the story, it's about a young man who was born in Barbados into slavery in the early 1800s. He's kind of given his freedom, but he also kind of runs away because the person who takes him away from Barbados is not his owner. It's his owner's brother who wants him to work on a project that requires Washington to use his artistic and scientific skills, skills that a young man born into slavery really wouldn't have had any use for if he remained in his former life. But Washington gets the opportunity to leave Barbados and go to Canada and England, and he's born on the cusp of slaves being emancipated. But while he has run away, he doesn't really get that benefit, and so there is a wanted poster, and this is the wanted poster on the front. So very interesting book. It was nominated for the Man Booker Prize in 2018. It didn't win, and while I was reading it, I wasn't sure that I thought that it was a great contender for the winning book, but it's one of those stories that after you finished it, it still lingers with you. And so I wanted to have this copy, and so I got it in November. Second book I got in November was A Ladder to the Sky by John Boyne. And this one is from the Book of the Month Club. I got a subscription, a gift subscription last Christmas, and I had two books remaining. I wanted to get one of them before the end of the year. So I chose A Ladder to the Sky by John Boyne, and I haven't read it yet, but he got a lot of claim last year for The Heart's Invisible Furies, which I read and loved, and I wanted to read this new book by him. I'm not sure what this book is about, but the back cover is empty, it's blank, and that is very interesting to me. So let's see what the synopsis is inside. Maurice Swift is handsome, charming, and hungry for fame. The one thing he doesn't have is talent, but he's not about to let a detail like that stand in his way. After all, a would-be writer can find stories anywhere. They don't need to be his own. Working as a waiter in a West Berlin hotel in 1988, Maurice engineers the perfect opportunity, a chance encounter with celebrated novelist Eric Ackerman. He quickly ingratiates himself with a powerful but desperately lonely older man, teasing out of Eric a terrible, long-held secret about his activities during the war. Perfect material for Maurice's first novel. Once Maurice has had a taste of literary fame, he knows he can stop at nothing in pursuit of that high. Moving from the Amalfi Coast, where he matches wits with Gore Vidal, to Manhattan and London, Maurice hones his talent for deceit and manipulation. Synopsis sounds very intriguing. However, there's usually a caveat when an author has had a very popular book. Quite often, the next book that they release is not as great. So beware of the hype. But I'm going to read this. I want to read this soon. The third book is probably the one that's going to be on my January TBR, because I'm going to be doing a buddy read of this one with beautifully bookish Bethany. She got me a copy of Marlon James's new book, Black Leopard, Red Wolf, another tome Marlon James. He loves his big books. Marlon James is the author of A Brief History of Seven Killings. He won the Man Booker Prize with that one a few years ago, and this is the next book that he's released since then. And I mean, look at the size. It's also a series or a trilogy, I'm not sure, but this is the first installment in some kind of a series. And Eric from Lonesome Reader read this book and raved about it. He called this potentially the best book of 2019 because the book hasn't been released yet. In fact, this is an ARC. You can see advanced reader copy, but Bethany did get Marlon James to sign it for me. And so this book is now one of my prized possessions because I have the signed copy of the ARC of this famous Jamaican writer. I'm going to be reading this one in January, I think. So that's my November haul. I'm going to be posting my December haul pretty soon. I'm also going to be posting my November recap, which I know is really late, but I'm still going to make it. So thanks for watching this video. We'll talk in the comments, and until next time, happy reading. Bye. I could stay like this, forever follow.